But they did get on national TV. I'm just saying.
That to be thankful for.
Looks like the Mayans had it wrong, people. December 2012 came and went without a hitch. But scientists have now put an expiration date on planet Earth, and the answer is 1.75 billion years to go. Tariq Malik, managing editor of space.com, with us now in studio. Have not seen you in a while.
Yeah, it's been a
while. All the scientists have been busy, I guess, right? Mixing things up. What did this study conclude?
So basically, this study is a model of what the habitability zone around our planet is, or for Earth. And they figured, you know, the Earth's been around for 4.5 billion years. You know, humans and everything that's alive now probably only has just under 2 billion years to go.
So we can have a good weekend anyway. Yeah. We can relax Saturday and Sunday.
Exactly.
Why is this important to people like you?
Well, what this is there's a belt, a Goldilocks zone around the sun that lets you and me and everything around us survive, this habitable zone. And what this lets them do is say, okay, this is how long this zone will last. And now I'm going to look at these distant stars, and there's planets there. How long do those zones last? How long can life be on those planets, too? So it's helpful for us. We can plan ahead.
Okay,
and
so
then also
there is a useful application for this, then. But what about the stray asteroid?
Oh, well.
What about the solar flare?
That
can we keep that 1.75 billion years away?
This study says, okay, if life keeps going on like now, well, then we've got this 1.75 billion years to go. If there is a big asteroid that we can't stop, that's going to change things. If there's a big solar flare that fries everything that we can't protect against, that's going to change things for us, though, for humans, right? Microbes, they've got their work.
So all this was based on a study of the sun.
Exactly. This model studies how the sun evolves over time. It's kind of like the middle of its life right now. About 5 billion years, it's got 5 billion more or so to go. And in this time frame, the sun just, it'll get bigger, it'll get hotter, and it just makes this zone where we live just a lot worse of a place. The oceans will evaporate. It won't be pleasant.
What iPhone will we be on at that point? Yeah.
Let's see. I guess like iPhone a bit.
Right. You know, what the study did conclude, though, is that it said that the planet will continue to get warmer as we move through. What does that suggest to those who believe in global warming?
Well, there is a caveat in that this heat, this hot zone that we're going to be in, really is going to affect like little tiny microbes and stuff like that. The study also says that for humans, we're going to reach kind of like a tipping point where it's too hot much earlier, largely because of climate change and things that are going on now.
1.75 billion. So we got time for a road trip.
That's right.
Thank you, Tariq.
Thanks,
Tariq Malik. Nice to see you. All right.